Look, I think all of us on this bench have had quite a few of these discussions on price risk, volatility, etc. I'm quite keen for us to move on a little bit this time. I think it's about time. The products that we all deal with, I've been talking about, have been around for quite a long time now. Even though that may not feel like it. And there are now numerous ones compared to the early days when there were perhaps one or two contracts to trade. I work for Stemcor Risk Management, which is a division of Stemcor, who came from my colleague David earlier, who runs the International Trade Division. SRM exists within the Stemcor Group for two main purposes. One is to attempt to manage risk that arises from our day-to-day activities within the group. And the other one is to try and develop and promote services and products that arise from the use of these derivatives to our customers and to new customers as well. I think Joe will be able to say a little bit as well about how he's a similar business profile in the positions we've done with, and a bit about what your various organisations are doing right now and how you view the services in this field developing.
Jeff Kable, I'm with JP Morgan, it's 2.5 years now. Before that, I was in the trucking industries. And effectively, run our build out of our first business, both from a financial standpoint and a physical trading standpoint. And effectively, the business is more called by our customers to help manage the increasing volatility in ferrous prices, be it the raw materials and the finished steel. And on top of that, there's obviously been a lot of changes in the physical contract marketplace with shorter term contracts, very spot driven contracts, both in raw materials and on the finished steel side. And so you have effectively an industry now which is second in the world, as far as flows, second to oil, having the same risk profile as many other industries, where a lot of other industries, whether they're buyers of steel, they're buyers of raw materials, or miners, or traders, effectively use risk management derivative tools to manage that risk, whether that's locking in the margin, whether that's helping to make more steel going into vehicles. And it's just a natural extension of what we see in the markets, and we see it more and more taking off. I think there's a bit of a drop off during the recession, but again, we've all sat here. Raw material prices are still volatile, so are steel prices, and this is just one tool to help manage those risks.
Maybe if we could jump you quickly, Martin, and go to Mike, because you have a similar profile, I guess, but we're perhaps more specific to brokerage.
Yeah, I think to introduce myself, my name is Michael Zeitler of BNP Paribas Commodity Futures, which is a part of BNP Paribas. There, more specifically, looking after the cleared aspects of commodity markets, more specific metals across the board. And one big part of that for the last few years has been steel, iron ore, coking coal. And again, for us, it's really trying to help our clients and customers to understand the role of these derivatives, how they can help them, how they can manage the risk that they incur going into these products, specifically through clearing, for example, and just try and generally help develop the market.
And Joe, could you tell us a little bit about what you guys are doing at Traffic with these products? I'll probably taking some notes.
I'm Joe Kamoff, I'm a Traffic Girl. We're quite a large trading company, quite developed on the oil and energy trading and on the non-ferrous business. And I think for quite some time we avoided steel for various reasons, but one of them was the business model that we developed in those other markets, oil and non-ferrous, was so heavily around building a physical book and having a liquid paper futures market to be able to hedge your risks. And for up until recently, it didn't feel like the right time to enter into that. And with the launch of several of these tools, it's not there yet. It's nowhere near to the level of how established it is in those other markets. But we said we need to get in and get involved, and the time's right to see what we can do. Because I think in some ways the traditional steel trading business is changing, and so we're seeing where we can fit in with that.
I'm asking, I our safety philosophy reasons. But I think one of the interesting things of the last 4 or 5 years is that there were a lot of assumptions when these products were first listed, first became an issue for the industry in general. And a lot of those assumptions have proved, whilst not wholly to be untrue, to perhaps to adapt to the reality of life. One of those is how we view derivative products. In the early days, there was a view that one or two would be enough. Can you tell us a bit about CME and your virtual steel mill and how that has adapted to what you see as the requirements for the
industry? Right. My background was initially from the physical market, selling nickel powders to stainless steel and other markets. And prior to joining the CME, I was at the LME to help to develop the billet contract there. One of the things that we tried to do was use one product as a proxy for the entire supply chain. And increasingly, I realized that that was difficult. While it might serve one particular industry, the industry in steel is enormous, and there are a number of different risk factors throughout the supply chain. So what we've tried to do at the CME Group is really take a holistic approach to the industry, knowing that this is a long-term investment for us, but really list a variety of contracts, which we call the virtual steel, that encompass raw materials of iron ore, metallurgical coal, scrap, billet, and hot rolled coil that link the entire supply chain. So it's quite a comprehensive approach. It has taken a long time to build these contracts and to really work and educate the market about how these work. But we're starting to see the fruits of that labor coming through and again, increasing growth in our hot rolled coil and our iron ore options contracts in particular. And now we're looking towards listing other contracts, particularly for the Asian market, where, as Colin was mentioning, there's a number of risk factors there and some exciting growth.
Never going to be the first business among the companies involved. And clearly, from the liquidity that's grown on CME and on various other platforms, there are a lot of people out there who are actively engaging with this. Obviously,
and that's a bit of a no-brainer because that's they're doing anyways for a long time, but it was more of a physical contact in standpoint when you had iron ore tracks. So it's not a big launch. So that's I think that's coming along. And then you're seeing others that traditionally the industrial
probably would be a conversation where you try to explain the product that somebody hasn't really looked at. It has changed a little bit as well as the way people feel about it in terms of trying to implement escalated clause to their contracts. They're going to be using things on the sell side while maybe the middle is a little bit, so to speak, to at least make it easier, if they're not active themselves, but at least make it easier for them to hedge themselves.
It does certainly seem to be a great deal more available to the next pricing. It's a great set of collaboration. I mean, Joe, is that